Welcome to the Freeform Knits podcast, episode 13. I am Haxann. You can find me on Instagram at the Freeform Knitter. You can find me on Ravelry as Haxann Evers, where I sell my knitting and crochet patterns. And show notes for this podcast will be in my blog. All these will be linked down below in the description box. There we go. That was take two. Sorry for this glare here. We have this whiteboard on the wall. It's like one of those stick-on whiteboards that you just paste on the wall and it's a whiteboard. And the light's causing it to make a glare. But this is where I have the most light, so we're just going with it. Okay. Let's jump right into finished objects, which also happens to be what I am wearing. And I love this so much. I am wearing the Dream Sweater by Claudia Q. This was a knit-along. I don't know if it's still ongoing. A knit-along by UKnit2, and they were having knit-along for two patterns by Claudia Q, this one, the Dream Sweater, and the sweater I showed last week, the Little Child Fox sweater. It was in last week. I keep messing up the name in my head. But I was still working on the body last week, I think. And as you can see, I now have a completed sweater. So first, the yarn I used for this was, I love this yarn, 100% acrylic yarn in the Toasted Almond colorway. And then the contrast color here was Yarn VID in the Rosewater colorway. And so I used less than 600 grams of the brown, and I knit the smallest size. I'm trying to think, like, I love this yarn skeins that come in 200 gram balls, two big skeins, and I used less than three skeins, so, and then I used less than half of this colorway. Okay, so a few things about this sweater. It's knit bottom up, and I can actually stand up, kind of, and show you. It is longer than I thought. I knit it longer than in the pattern. So the pattern, I think, for my size, was supposed to be like 14 and a half inches the body before you joined in. I think I did close to 16, if not more than 16 inches, somewhere in that range. And the arms, I did 10 of these pattern repeats. Like if you knit the pattern, it's like, this is like the stripe repeat. And I did 10 of these. I did 10 of these for the sleeve. I thought I'd have to do the same amount for the body, but I actually ended up doing 9 for the body. And it's a really nice size, like the sleeves are full length. And I like to be able to do this with my sleeves if I'm going for a full length sleeve. So there's that. And then, so it's longer than I thought it would be, which is, I'm happy about the bottom-up sweater I knit in the past. I made it shorter because I wasn't sure how long to do it, because that's the thing with bottom-up sweaters. It can be a little bit harder to plan how long your finished sweater is going to be, mostly because of row gauge. Row gauge, if your row gauge differs from a pattern's, like, you can't really do anything about it. And so I never even bothered to check row gauge. Truth. And I'm blocking the color. So the yoke is deeper than I thought it would be. Like, my armpit is here, so I've got a good 3 inches of under the yoke. I have a deep yoke because of my row gauge. So the color work was fun. I like the color work. The only thing I probably, if I were going to knit this again, or really as I was knitting it, I realized I probably should have done this, I would not do these little star patterns. You can't really tell on the camera, but these, they're, as you can tell, they're really far apart, which means you have to trap your floats, which you have to do anyway around here anyway, because you kind of have long sections where you don't use the pink. So my floats are kind of loose, even though I tried to catch them. So, got some long floats. And I thought about when I was up here, I thought about just not doing these, but I wasn't gonna rip back. I don't take back my work. I really don't. So, is that. It's not a big problem. I keep tugging the floats when I'm not wearing it. When I'm wearing it, I don't really notice. So that's good. And yeah, and the only other thing about the sweater, the same problem I had with the little sweater I knit last week. The short rows were weird. I did do short rows, if you can tell. The back does come down higher. But maybe I just don't know how to read short rows. Maybe that's my problem. Because the way it's written in the pattern, it just doesn't, I can't see it working with the work on my needles. Maybe that's me. I don't know. It's probably me. Because I don't think other people have had this issue with the pattern. I don't know. But I looked at it. I couldn't make sense of it. So I just winged it. The beginning of round was right on the back of this sleeve. So then I just figured out what would be the exact back, not counting the sleeve, for the back, and then did the short rows across there. I think I did 6 short rows total. So yeah, that's it. I love it. I do love the sweater. It's really nice, and it's really warm. Worsted weight sweaters, always in my head, I think they're going to be heavier than they actually end up being. And just so warm, and it's not heavy at all, it's just warm. So I love it. So that's my first finished object. Oh, I knit this on a US 9, 5.5 millimeter, and I never change needles for the ribbing, so the ribbing's also new on that. Yep, that's it. So I did make notes. What do I want to talk about next? Oh, so for the crochet, I have a finished object, and it's not really a recently finished object. I made this a while ago, and I love it. So, I talked about last week how this time of year I make a lot, find myself crocheting a lot more, specifically crocheting more toys, stuffies. So I have Pichu. So here's Pichu. Pichu was crocheted using a 5 millimeter hook, which I think is an 8 hook. She was made out of various colors of I Love This Yarn brand. I don't know how much she is total, but got her tail and her legs. And I actually just secured her head a bit more, her ears a bit more, because she's made in parts. She's an amigurumi toy, and I'm not good at sewing. So I kind of had to secure everything a bit more. So the pattern is a free pattern. I'm going to link it in my show notes. The free pattern is a really good pattern. The only, not really a complaint, I would say, is more just a styling choice, I think, of the designer. Pichu, her body and has a lot of stitches that you don't decrease for. So, well, her head is, you know, a sphere shape, you know, you start small up here, you go down, and you decrease. Her body is not that. So it made sewing it on a little tricky. Even more so if you are so bad at sewing like me. That's why I kind of had to secure her a little bit more. So she's a little wobbly still, but not so much that she's going to lose her head. And I just did safety eyes for the eyes because I didn't feel like figuring out a lot of crochet patterns, amigurumi patterns, especially Pokemon, you know, they use felt for the eyes. I don't have felt, so I usually end up either sewing eyes, crocheting eyes. But for this, I just decided I found safety eyes, so it looks good. It's good. I still highly recommend the pattern, especially if you. Can you get Pichu out of it? I love Pichu. It's gonna be a gift for my goddaughter, actually. So she's nice and soft. I think I stuffed her mostly with bits of yarn. Like I saved my yarn tail and everything. So I think That's a lot of that stuff in there. So that's one part of the Christmas gift. And while we're on gifts for my goddaughter, I'm going to reach down here, pull out her other gift, which is this. Okay. It's small, she's one, and this is probably going to be big for her, because she's tiny. My goddaughter is tiny, so I don't want to get the pattern wrong for this. I knit this a while ago. This pattern is called Greetings from Iceland by Vera Sannin, and it's a free pattern, I'll link it. It's on Ravelry, so it's really nice, and I did knit this a while ago, so let me see how much I can remember. I know the yarn is Yarn Bee Sweet Delight DK. That's the silver. And then I think the white, I'm looking at it, I don't remember the brand. It was just like a sock yarn I got, just to use for contrast. And then actually the pink is a Knit Picks yarn, one of their stroll tonals. So very little color work, but super pretty. And because this yarn, though it's called a DK, it's gray, it's actually a fingering. But I did knit this on a US-7, which is a 4.5 millimeter needle. So it's a very loose gauge. And the color is also loose, and it's also acrylic. Everything's acrylic except for the Knit Picks. And then I think the sock yarn is acrylic and nylon blend. So, but I still make color work out of it, and it's good. It's, if you look close, especially where I'm looking on the back, maybe it's not going to show up. Kind of not the best tension stuff. And there's some floats. Floats aren't bad. Floats up in this sweater, now that I'm thinking about it, not my best. But that's okay. So, yeah, I don't remember the sizes included in the Greetings from Iceland pattern. I'm thinking my gauge was probably different from hers, and then I played with the size, so I don't remember what size this is or what I'm thinking the Greetings from Iceland pattern is actually a worsted. I might be wrong, and that I hacked it to get what I got. I knit this a while ago. I don't remember. So yeah, but this will be a Christmas gift. Alongside Pikachu I talked about last week and the other sweater I made last week, which will be for my goddaughter's brother. So yeah, I think those will be really nice gifts. Okay, so I still have more finished objects. Let's talk about what was a whip last week. These socks. This is a DK weight sock pattern that I'm writing up. It's going to be called the Delightful Knit. I'm getting my own pattern name wrong. It'll be called Delightful Knit Socks. I wasn't getting it wrong. I'm working on the pattern. It's going to be. I'm going to include the stitch pattern for this, this garter rib, the stitch pattern I showed you last week on those other socks that I was trying out. And it's going to be DK weight sock pattern with my DK weight sock shortcut heel included. That was exciting. I'm also working on the fingering version for the shortcut socks. Shortcut heel. Yep, I can speak. So, I talked about these last week. I knit them out of Baby B Sweet Delight, 60% acrylic, 40% polyamide, and this colorway is the Puppy Kisses colorway. Just a really nice blue speckle. It woke up so fast, and I love it. I don't think I finished this long after the podcast last week, so yep. Oh, and I did knit these ones on a 5, which I like this gauge a lot better than the 6. So it's just a little bit tighter. And my stitch gauge stays the same, but the fabric is just a little bit snugger. So yeah. That's what we recommended in the pattern. I don't like knitting at tight gauges. Like, I might like the look and the feel of a tight fabric, but if the knitting and while knitting it is too tight, I don't like it. So I was happy to see that the 5 is a good compromise for that. Okay, so I still have more finished objects, so I'm gonna bend down and grab them. We got 3 more, right? Okay. So how I like to knit, how I like to have my whips organized, I like to have a sweater, I like to have a sock, and then I like to have a small project or two.
I'm sorry.
I like to have like quick projects that I can, you know, if I want something really quick and, you know, usually worsted to work on. So sweater, sock, and then little extras. So that's what these little extras are. So I actually had finished this, I finished those socks, and I hadn't had anything else to cast on. So I needed... So I needed another project. So I just grabbed a ball of worsted and my needles and needed to make a Christmas gift. So I made these gloves, fingerless gloves. So no pattern, just freeformed it. I cast on, I'm thinking 32 stitches around on a US 9 worsted weight yarn. And this yarn is, I love this yarn, 100% acrylic. I don't know the color, but as you can see, it's this nice fall variegated yarn. And I did something a bit different for the cuff. I love ribbing. I don't like working ribbing. It's gotta give me something extra to make it worth my while, so I always usually cop out on ribbing. Like, my sock cuffs, it's very rare that they go past 12 rounds. And, you know, same with this. These took me off. I think I did a 15 row cuff here. So ribbing kind of takes me a while to get through. It's not my favorite thing to work. But for this, I managed through it by making it into like a basket weave texture. I just alternated the pillars of rib, kept the stretch, and just made it a bit longer. So I did that. I think I did 16, 24 rounds of rib. And then my problem with gloves is I never know how much work I should do before I do my thumb gusset. Like, I did a gusset here, and I ended up, if the gloves were for me, I probably would have done 5 rounds, but because my hands are a bit bigger than most people's, I only did 2 or 3, I think 3. So it still fits, it'll fit the recipient, but I always worry about that because I don't want, like, a really long cuff. And if I do too much between the cuff and the thumb gusset, it'll be the long glove. So that's just something I always think about. So yeah, these gloves, and they almost match. I'm really happy about this. They almost match perfectly. Not quite like the way you're looking at it. They look, actually, it's weird. I keep looking at them because it's weird, because like at first glance to me, it looks like they don't match. And then I look back and it's like, oh no, they do. But you can kind of see here, the red starts earlier than it does here. So they almost match perfectly. They match just enough so that anyone else who didn't knit them will look at them and say they match perfectly. And I actually knit these in a day. Like, if that's what you're thinking for, you know, worsted weight yarn, Christmas gifts, done in a day. Perfect. So that's one of those extra projects. And then I need 2 more extra projects because quick gift knits. So I made this hat out of the scraps of this color here, the Yarn Bee ID Rosewater colorway. I made a cable bean and I really love this hat, and I'll try it on because my hair is up, so it looks weird. But I did 2x2 rib. I think I cast on 80 stitches. Again, US 9 is my favorite needle to use for worsted. 2x2 rib. I did 1 purl row here. just because I've seen that in other hats and thought I'd try it. And then I did 4x4 and then cables every, I'm going to say 7th row. Yes, every 7th row was a cable row. And then I did what I call cheater decreases, which I just did knit two togethers, knit two, purl two all the way around. No, two knit two togethers. I did knit two together, knit two together, purl two together all the way around, knit two, purl two all the way around, then decreased again. You know, quick cheater decreases to get a good look. And I really am so surprised how much I love this hat. And I'm gonna definitely write up the pattern, and I wanna do a cowl with it. I think it would be so nice. But yeah, that's this hat. And then my last finished object, which I really like. Again, another quick Christmas gift that I needed to come up with something. And so I made this. I crocheted it. It's a pouch. That wasn't painfully obvious from first glance. So I crocheted this. I used Yarn Bee Low Pill Acrylic, I think is what it's called. I don't remember the fiber content off the top of my head. So I just whipped this up. I think I crocheted 28 single crochets and then did the technique where you go around the chain, crochet into the bottom of the chain to kind of get this rectangle in the round thing. If you crochet, I hope you understand that. But started at the bottom and then just crocheted around and then did three rows of single crochet, three rows of single crochet back loop, up three times total, and then did a round of slip stitches where I stopped to do these three buttonhole chain loops, and then finished it off, and then did a single crochet handle, which I just thought was a really nice detail. And then I found these three buttons that actually, you can see it on this one, clearer, have like little knit stitches, a couple of knit stitches. I thought that was really nice. So yeah, it just makes a good pouch for just anything, so you don't drop it like I just did. And yeah, I really love this. I crocheted it on a H-hook 5.5 millimeter, not 5.5, H-hook 5 millimeter. Whips. Okay, so let's talk about whip I kept talking about. Talk about Pikachu. So I said last week that I need to assemble Pikachu, and I did for the most part. Here he is. There's Pikachu. He is missing his eyes, obviously, and his tail. I was gonna do that today, but in transporting my stuff, I have to find the tails again. I need to bring crochet up with me to do his eyes. I'm gonna do that today, and I couldn't. I have to find my crochet hook in his tail. I know where they are. I just have to find them. And I didn't tie these in yet because I'm thinking I put them too far apart and too high up. They're probably gonna have to be moved once I figure out what to do with his eyes. I was gonna do, I thought about doing safety eyes like Pikachu, but I don't think big Pikachu here can pull it off. But before I forget, let me tell you the name of this pattern because I love this pattern so much. This pattern, did I write it down? I did not put it in my notes. I have to remember to do that. The pattern is by Sabrina's Crochet is the website, I believe. It's gonna be linked. I'll put that in my notes. Sabrina's Crochet, she has like a website and she does a bunch of Pokemon patterns. Some Pikachu is free. You have to make an account on her website and then you purchase the pattern. You don't purchase the pattern, it's a free pattern. But you check out the pattern, it goes in your email inbox. And it's such a nice pattern. Well, the best thing I like about it is that it is one piece. His body is one piece, so there's no wobbly head thing that like PHU has going on. So it's really great, and the tail's really nice too. I'd show it to you, but he doesn't have it yet. So he will be done soon, very soon. I love his size. I might have to make another one for me. I love a big Pikachu plush. So yeah, his Pikachu, and the same yarns that I use for Pikachu. I love this yarn, black, red, yellow. You know, that's it. That's it for Pikachu. Pikachu. This is Pikachu. I know that. Okay. So, I have two other finished whips. No more finished objects. Two more whips. Talk about first. I actually have a half-finished object. My shortcut heel sock recipe. Should probably learn the name of my own patterns. That would be nice. Okay. So, this sock, is my basic sock recipe that I'm getting ready to publish. The color, the main color, the self-striping yet color, is Patton's Croy socks glare label in the mid-century stripes colorway. It is a 2575 wool vinyl blend. And then this cuff is a Patton's Croy in white. This heel and this green are Yarn Bee minis, 25% nylon, 75% acrylic. So the reason I did three different colors, contrasting colors, is simply because I thought they looked nice. I couldn't decide what color to do for the contrast, and I didn't have enough. I would have done blue off the contrast, didn't have enough blue. So, yep, and this is my shortcut heel in garter stitch. It's one side. Out there, I love it. It's so easy to work. It eliminates any holes in the gusset, which is a problem I have, especially with my bad picking up stitches skills. So, I'm so excited to get this pattern out. It's going to have 5 sizes. And a bunch of shoe chart foot length things, so that you know you can just take the pattern and just do it. Everything's there, and I love it so much. So I've actually started the other sock. Just started it, and they're actually going to match, which I was surprised about. I had to pull out some yarn for yarn management purposes, but yeah, they're going to match. Maybe like one row difference, which is very good considering that my self-striping socks usually never match. So yep, and I only have the 50 gram ball, so that's why the whole contrast. So I actually have it in this sock bag with all my pins on it. This is actually a bag I made. Just did a simple outer shell and lined it. So yeah. That's that whip. Last whip is my new sweater. And I'm so excited for this sweater. I've been wanting to make this sweater for so long. So the pattern I'm using is from Ann Budd's Handy Top Down Sweater Construction. I don't have the book with me, but that's the book. It's just like the title. All top-down sweater constructions, set and sleeves, circular yokes, raglans, set and sleeves, circular yokes, raglans, and there's a fourth one. I don't remember what it is, though. That's gonna bug me. Circular yokes, there's a fourth one. I just don't know what it is. But that's the book, and I'm making a circular yoke. Here it is. And it looks small, but it is not small. I feel like circular yokes always look small. And I'm pretty far. So I'm just using the counts for the smallest size in my stitch gauge. I'm using, if you look at the book, it's like a recipe thing. You just pick your size, you pick the number of stitches you're getting per inch. I'm getting I'm using the counts for 5 stitches per inch. I'm actually getting 5.5 stitches per inch, so mine's going to be a little bit bigger, which is good because I think the size I'm using is a 34 inch bust, and I like to do my sweaters in the 36, 37 range. So it fits perfectly. And another hack I did is I eliminated the first round. Like for her patterns, she has you cast on, a provisional cast on, and then do an increase round right away. And that makes your neckline come up higher and tighter. And I hate that. I hate when my necklines are too tight. Most t-shirts I don't wear. Because like a lot of the crew neck t-shirts just come up too high, and I hate that feeling of the sweater being too high. Like, I was worried about this neckline when I was knitting it, and I think I actually did less ribbing than it was called for because I was afraid of that. So I like, this is the highest I go with a neckline. Very rarely I have one turn leg over, that's it. And I was really worried about this because I didn't know where to accommodate the fact that I cut out things. Like with circular yokes, you increase, you knit a little, you increase again. And I didn't know if, because I cut out stuff, whether or not my yoke would be too shallow. I've had that problem in the past with circular yokes. But this works out just right. I tried it on. It's perfect. So yeah, I really love it. I'm using Yarn B, Must Be Merino, in the Rust colorway. You can't see it. I have only 4 skeins of this. I used one, took one skein exactly to do the yoke. Like, on the row I was separating for my sleeves, I ran out of the first yarn. So I might need one more skein, I don't know. It's a DK weight, so I know I needed another skein when I need a worsted weight out of this brand of yarn. I don't know about the DK, and I'm using just black. The same brand for the hems. You know, this will be on the cup of the sleeves and the brim of the body. So yep. And then for the garter detail, I figured out I did the garter every 6th row. So 5 rounds of knitting, and then the 6th row is a purl row, which, because of the way purl stitches end up, it makes it look like you have 6 rows of stockinette here, because when you do a purl row, you get that extra V right underneath it. So yeah, I love this sweater so much. I can't wait for it to be done. I've been wanting to knit it for so long, and I'm so glad I finally am. So I think I'm using a 4.5 millimeter. These are my Knit Picks nickel plated needles. And it's just straight on going. This is the bag I use for my sweaters. This is a bag I got years ago. It was from an Etsy shop, Maggie's Bags. Maggie's Bags, that I've washed it multiple times, so you can't really see the label, but I have no idea if this Etsy shop still makes bags. But it's the perfect size for sweaters. So yep. And that's all my whoops. The only thing I have left to talk about is a little design talk. And I took off my sweater so I could show you properly. This is the cowl I was working on last week. This is the Winter Song cowl. And I love it so much. It's just the perfect cowl. I love cowls. I love being able to hide my face in the cold mornings. I did this design of the two flaps to just make sure that it's really tucked into your coat. It's perfect. And my favorite thing about this is the stitch pattern. It's this fake honeycomb slip stitch pattern that is really, really fun to work. This cowl whips up so fast. I think after I finished the podcast last week is when I finished this the same day. Or the day after. I don't remember, but it was really, really quick. So let me take it off to show you clearer. So it's just this nice tube like here's the cowl portion right here, and then the same thing down here, just knit flat. So it's the winter zone cowl, it's knit flat, or it's joined in the round, and then you add some stitches to join it, get this nice side panel. And it's just, can we just appreciate that slip stitch texture? I love it so much. It's so fun to work. So I actually need testers for this cowl, and if you are interested, please just message me on Instagram or on Ravelry. I would be so happy to have you as a tester. So it's worsted weight 9. I knit it on a 9. And I love it so much. So if you're interested, just message me. All I have to show. That's it. That's a wrap. And that's my messy hair. So if you stuck around this long, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you liked some of my work. I hope inspired you for maybe to make some crochet toys, because that's a lot of what I'm doing. So yeah, thank you for watching. Happy crafting!